FMU, you're on the air.
Hey, Tom.
Hey.
It's Andy from Lake Newbridge.
Hey, Andy. How are you doing?
What's going on?
Not a whole lot. Just kind of holding it together here.
It's a fun show tonight.
Oh, thanks.
I just want to say I love the show. I do want to take you to task for something that you said last week, though.
Okay.
Sorry.
Sure.
You said that Fergal Sharkey wrote the Undertones classic Teenage Kicks.
Did I say that?
Yeah.
Okay.
I've got it on my computer if you want to hear it, but he didn't write it.
Who wrote it then?
The band's rhythm guitarist, John O'Neill.
Was he a primary songwriter in the group?
He wrote most of them, and it's interesting. The Undertones are, if you think about it, they're sort of like The Who in that their lead singer didn't write any of the songs that he sang. It's kind of interesting.
He's sort of singing somebody else's vision almost.
Exactly. Yeah. So I'm not trying to bust your bees there, but I gotta say also I'm a little disappointed that you didn't pick my logo.
Oh, for the logo contest?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, which one was your logo?
Mine was the one with a bass on it saying "I'm hooked on the best show."
I remember that one being pretty creative, but there can only be so many winners. We actually were going to only do one winner and had three.
Oh, okay.
So we kind of.
I'm just learning Photoshop, so it's sort of tough. It's harder than you think it's going to be.
Is it? I've never really gotten into doing graphic arts.
Yeah. You didn't strike me as being the kind of guy that would be able to figure that stuff out.
What's that?
I said you don't strike me as being the kind of guy who could figure out something like that.
Oh, so I'm not. Good.
I'm just busting your bees again. Oh, I'm sorry.
So you're kind of in a little mood tonight, aren't you?
A little bit. Hey, you didn't go see U2 last night in Philly, did you?
No.
Did you hear who guested?
I heard something happen. What happened?
Bruce and Patty got up.
She got up there, and the two. What did they do?
I think from what I heard, and I read this online on U2USA.net today, that at the end of Beautiful Day.
Sure.
They went into a little bit of, I think, the promised land.
Mm-hmm.
And then Bruce came out, and I think they did maybe My Hometown or something like that. And then Patty came out, and they did, like, this jam. But it sounded like it was super cool. I wish I could have been there.
Well, that would be a cool surprise.
Yeah. You know, what I'm looking forward to, I don't know if you're a fan or not, but they're putting out that Hammersmith 75 show on DVD.
I heard it's, like, going to be a Born to Run, like three-disc set or
exactly,
something?
Exactly, yeah, it's going to be great. Hey, speaking of DVDs, you see the Dylan thing?
You know, I've seen most of it. I was kind of taking my time with it because I was really excited about it, the No Direction Home.
Yeah, I saw all of it on PBS. I didn't see any of the, you know, the special, whatever extras they call it. But, do you know the whole backstory with him and Baez?
The whole backstory with him and Joan Baez?
Yeah, well, like, you know, she kind of takes him under her proverbial wing. And, you know, lets him open for her for all these U.S. shows. And now he's hot as hit by this point. And they go over to England.
Yeah.
It's his tour. You know, the Don't Look Back tour, basically, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And guess who don't invite Joan Baez up on stage to do anything?
So it's almost like it was like a one-way thing. He did not reciprocate.
Wham, bam, thank you, Joan.
Yeah. Like,
that's how I see it.
Yeah, that's not
not very cool.
That's kind of not that good. You know,
But I think Madonna and all those people kind of have that. You gotta use people to get where you want to go.
I guess if you have your eyes on the prize to that degree.
I've heard the same thing about you.
What do you mean?
You know, how you got to where you are.
Well, you mean like I'm burning through people?
Sort of, yeah.
Yeah, that I would say is not true.
Well, I get into a lot of arguments with, you know, a bunch of folks from my school about it.
Really?
They tell me that you think you're this big fish in a little pond.
Uh-huh. You said you're where, Andy?
Oh, Lake Newbridge.
Oh, man, you guys got really pounded with all this rain last week. With all the rain. I mean, last week it was raining so hard. I know just over there with the water levels and everything that it was pretty intense.
Oh, yeah. You know, I did hear it seemed like there was some kind of action going on up there, but we're all fine down here, yeah.
What do you mean? Do you mean like down in that area? I mean, because
in the lake, yeah.
You mean in the lake? I say I'm kind of losing you. You mean in the lake, like on a boat?
No, in the lake.
In the lake.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
What do you think it means? Under the water.
Exactly. What does that? I'm asking you where you live, and you're saying you live in the lake.
And if you would listen, you would hear me say I live in the lake under the water.
Well, I guess how would be the next question I would ask.
I'm a carp.
What do you mean? What do you mean a carp? Do you mean like the fish carp?
Yes.
So I'm losing you here for a second. You're saying you're a fish?
Yeah. Why?
Because you're talking to me, first of all.
Well, you're talking to me. We're all God's creatures. I just happen to live under the water.
So I'm talking to a carp right now.
Yeah. Why?
Because I don't think I've ever talked to a carp before.
Well, first time for everything. I ate what they call a Skittle the other day. Someone thrown that in the water.
A Skittle, like the candy, a Skittle.
Exactly, yeah. It was pretty good.
A Skittle.
I see ads for it on TV, but never really had one before. Hey, guess where I am?
Where?
Aquaman's place.
So Aquaman lives in Lake Newbridge?
Yeah. Basically, he spends most of his time in the Atlantic, you know, doing what he does. But he's got this summer castle in Lake Newbridge.
I'm really confused here. Now, is that how you're listening to the show?
Yeah, I mean, he's got this slamming joint here. He's got Monster Plasma TV, Xbox, killer Mac computer, Bose sound system. That's what I'm listening on right now.
So you're listening to the show on a Bose sound system,
mm-hmm,
in Aquaman's what, castle?
Yeah.
Under the water in Lake Newbridge.
Yeah.
But how are you talking on a phone? You're a fish.
It's a headset, dummy.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Thank you for being so forgiving.
Well, no apology could be too big.
I mean, you have to realize the fact that I'm talking to a fish.
Oh, that's good stuff.
What are you eating?
I'm drinking.
What are you drinking?
Brandy.
Brandy?
Yeah.
You're drinking, well, I guess it's Aquaman's brandy.
Well, he won't miss a bottle. I already went through a bottle of bourbon. The good stuff.
So are you like pals with Aquaman or something?
Well, define pals.
Are you friends with him?
We live in the same lake.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, here's how it works out. He's not here from, like, September to May, because, okay, you know, this is, like, his summer joint.
Uh-huh.
So I figure it's a waste for this cool place not to get used, you know?
So he kind of doesn't know you're using his pad.
Oh, yeah. I mean, he would have a bath if he knew I was in here drinking his bourbon.
He would have a what?
A bath.
Oh, so that's, like, fish slang or something?
You guys would probably say, like, having a bird. Yeah, the limbed.
The limbed.
Yeah.
So we're that's what we are to you?
Yeah.
You don't see anything weird about this?
About me kind of moving into Aquaman's territory or what? I mean,
no, just
dude can't do anything by himself. It's pathetic.
Who, Aquaman?
Yeah. I mean, you know his whole thing, right?
Uh-huh.
He summons all the aquatic inhabitants to do his bidding.
Uh-huh.
I just pretend I don't hear him.
So, like, when he sends out a message saying that he needs help, like helping rescue somebody.
Newsflash for you and your listeners. The percentage of, like, rescue missions he summons us for, it's like 8%.
Really? Like,
yeah.
What would be the other 92%
then?
Oh,
well, just the other week, he gets all the fish together to move this really big, bulky roll-top desk.
So he was moving a desk into his castle or
yeah,
something?
Yeah, it was big.
Uh-huh.
It was so dumb-looking, too. It's like, dude, who are you, Button Gwinnett or something? It's like Laura Ingalls would be embarrassed to be seen writing on one of these things.
So,
I don't know, maybe he thinks it's kitschy.
This big roll-top desk.
Yeah.
So you're the only fish that kind of doesn't help him?
No, I mean, you know, I'm not the only one that's sort of down with Agua Douche. Or down on him, I should say.
Yeah.
I mean, he's got this whole vibe that screams, look how great I am, you know?
Really?
You know it all stems from the fact that he walks on land.
Uh-huh.
It's like, take away that from him, and he's just like me, Rodney, Chuck, and Mike.
That he's no different. He's just another fish. If he didn't have limbs.
Yep.
But everybody else is kind of on board. It seems like you have your little crew there.
Yeah, Rodney, Chuck, and Mike.
And you guys don't listen to Aquaman.
No, you know what we call ourselves?
What?
LN50G.
LN50G. What is that?
Lake Newbridge 5, Original Gangsters.
So you're actually like a little gang.
A little posse, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. We almost had it out with Aquaman and his crew in June.
Really?
Yeah. Well, man, these no-gills. They were water skiing.
These what?
No-gills.
Oh,
like, you're a no-gill.
Oh, so that's one of your, that's another one of the insults.
That's like a candy-coated one. You don't want to hear the other ones.
Okay. I'll take your word for it since we're on the radio. I don't want to hear.
Well, anywho, these no-gills are water skiing, and this totally hot one, she wipes out.
Uh-huh.
And Chuck swims up, and he gives her a little bite on her exposed breast.
Oh,
can I say that on the
air? You just did, but
I can get that through, right?
You just did, so.
Okay, well, oh, man, she freaks out.
Of course she does. She just got attacked by a fish.
Well, it was in good fun, you know?
Ugh, that's so disgusting.
Well, anywho, Aquaman comes from out of nowhere. And I swear this cat does not sleep.
Uh-huh.
Toot problem, if you ask me.
Toot problem?
Yeah.
So you're saying Aquaman's doing blow?
Yeah. You didn't hear it from me, though, right?
Uh-huh.
So anyway, he comes out of nowhere and he starts lecturing Chuck about, you know, lake etiquette, and Chuck's all, back off, old man. And Aquadouche goes, you want me to deposit you in the next fishing boat that comes along?
Really?
And at that point, I'm ready to pounce, because Aquafart, he's been hitting on my old lady Sheila, like, all summer.
Aquaman's hitting on, like, another fish?
Yeah. He was all, dude, I didn't know she was your chick. And if I had a dime for every story I've heard about Aquaman clocking some fish's old lady,
uh-huh,
I'd be rich. I'd be living in this castle. But he uses the whole, I used to have a TV show line all the time. It's pretty sad.
I don't think I want to know anything about, like, first of all, Aquaman's kind of a hero to
people. To you, maybe. Because you watch the cartoon, right?
Well, you see the comic book and everything.
Well, the comic book is heavily whitewashed.
Really?
You know, there's a theory down here that Aquatool plays it like he's a ladies' man.
Yeah.
To deflect those rumors.
Rumors. So what? I can only guess there's, like, rumors questioning his sexuality.
You haven't been reading the Lake Star, have you? Sounds like you have.
What is the Lake Star?
It's a tabloid.
So you guys actually have, like, newspapers and stuff down there?
Oh, yeah.
But you're like fish.
We have everything you guys have, but we just don't, you know, flaunt it, you know?
Okay, so that's a rumor.
You didn't hear from me, but he's been romantically linked with the Submariner.
Really?
Yeah, Prince Neymar.
Ugh, that's kind of creepy, like the little, because they're different. I mean, not the fact that it's like a gay thing. It's not that.
Well,
no, you're saying that it is. I'm saying it isn't.
A little bit, you know? I mean, it's...
I'm saying it's
look,
the fact
all
that
I know
like
is
two
dude was here all of August.
Who, the Submariner?
Yeah, and let me just say this. They made quite a spectacle of themselves at Diamici's.
At where?
Diamici's.
What is Diamici's?
It's an Italian joint on East 23rd.
East 23rd what? Of where? Under the lake?
Yeah.
So you have, like, streets and everything down there?
Yeah, it's right by City Hall. Like a block from the Hard Rock.
You have a Hard Rock Cafe?
Yeah.
Under the lake?
Yeah.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
How come, like, we don't see it when we're, like,
it's
swimming?
Deep. It's a lot deeper than you think it is.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, anyway, Submariner, it turns out, was, like, mad about something that Aquadork said, and Submariner throws his cognac in Aquatool's face.
Really?
They're basically asked by the maitre d' to take it outside.
Uh-huh.
And this is a 5-star joint. It's not like Hojo's, you know.
Uh-huh.
You know, they get thrown out of the restaurant, and of course they both pull that do-you-know-who-we-are crap, you know?
Yeah.
Like, you don't catch Mike Newman doing that kind of stuff.
Who's Mike Newman?
He's the power forward for the Lake Newbridge Royals, our semi-pro basketball team.
And is he a fish also?
He's a bass. Why?
It's freaky. It's just freaky.
A question for Vu.
Yeah?
Why are you defending Aquaman and Submariner?
I thought they were heroes.
I'm getting the vibe like you're kind of down on me for some reason.
Well, it seems like you're definitely throwing them under the bus. Like you're maybe going a little bit out of your way to badmouth them.
They're pretty douchey.
I just, the one thing I will say is that when I kind of made a sound there of disgust, I was not making a sound of disgust. It was two dudes hooking up. I was making it because I guess it's maybe.
Well,
two.
I was.
Yeah, well, it's clear you were.
I don't think it's right.
I understand. I can.
Right.
I couldn't miss that.
Well.
So you kind of are a little bit homophobic.
Look, let's keep my beliefs out of this, okay?
Uh-huh.
You're pulling for him because he has hands and breathes air. I know it.
Well, I can relate to him.
We're so sick of your stuff. We're just as good as you air breathers.
I never discriminated against fish.
You eat them, though, don't you?
Sometimes.
Just for that, I'm not sending you my band CD.
What is your band?
We're called the Hey Now.
The Hey Now?
Yeah.
And what do you guys sound? Where'd you get that name?
We're kind of garagey. Kind of like the Greenhorns.
Really? You guys sound like the Greenhorns.
Yeah.
So you're kind of into garage rock?
Oh, yeah. I play guitar in Farfisa, and I sing also.
I don't even want to ask how you play guitar and Farfisa.
Well, it's all special stuff down here. It's all adapted to, you know, our thing.
To accommodate you.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. You know what our album's called?
What?
Carpe ADM.
That's a really bad pun.
It's Carpe's. C-A-R-P-S,
yeah.
The letter A, the letter D, the letter M, because the guys in the band, it's a power trio, Andy, myself, Doug, and Matt.
Wow.
You know what some of our songs are?
Yeah.
Hook, Line, and Sinker.
Uh-huh.
Having a Halibut Time.
Yeah.
And Don't Block My C.
Ugh.
Yeah.
Well, they're not all just puns.
Well.
I don't like it.
You don't like it? Oh, yeah. Jeepers.
I'm actually glad you're not going to send me your record now.
Oh, well, what is your whole deal? Like, you're talking really tough, you know?
What do you mean I'm talking tough?
You're talking like, I don't know, it's like the vibe is just douchey, you know? It's like,
well, you come in here and you're running Aquaman. It sounds like you need to, it sounds like you really want to throw down.
Hey, look, jerk. I'm pretty well connected with a certain bunch that operates just off the shore, if you know what I mean.
Uh-huh.
You don't want to mess with these cats.
Yeah?
All I need to do is get the word to them, and next time you and your family go for a dip at Ocean City...
Yeah?
I hope you have an ambulance on call, because it's not going to be pretty.
So you just are threatening to just... Your friends, what are they?
You saw the flick, didn't you?
What's the flick?
I think it was like a trilogy. Maybe there were four of them even. One was in 3D.
Oh, Jaws?
Yeah.
So you're friends with, like, what, a great white?
Try a whole bunch of them.
Yeah, so they're going to come and attack my family if we go swimming at the beach.
Maybe your family. You, definitely, yes.
Me?
Yeah.
So you talk about talking tough and then letting other people do your dirty work.
Hey, it's just like Hoffa did.
What's that?
He would call the shots, and then other guys would, you know, hack guys up.
Yeah?
I'm sort of like a Don in training.
Oh, so you're like a big shot. You kind of just do the talking, and people jump.
Yeah, I pretty much call the shots for all the
You guys carp. Can't even jump, right?
Oh, man. You just keep digging it deeper, don't you?
Oh, I'll fight you. Why don't you and I just square off?
Okay, I'm ready.
Where do you want to meet?
I don't breathe air, so it's going to have to be on my turf.
Okay, let's fight at the edge of the shore.
Let's do it. How about this coming Saturday?
Gladly.
Let's do it.
I'll fight you. How will I even know it's you? I'll just look for the stupid-looking fish.
I wear a beret.
You wear a beret?
Yeah, why?
Oh, I hate you so much.
Oh, I'm going to pull you into the water, and from there on out, you saw Piranha, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're going to get piranha'd.
So there's piranhas in Lake Newbridge.
There will be by Saturday, yeah.
So you're going to call some in.
Oh, yeah.
This I've got to see.
Take out insurance, because your wife's going to need it.
Yeah, well, bring it on.
Andy's going to chomp you.
I hate you so much, and I'm going to pound you.
Never. Dun, dun. Dun, dun. Dun, 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 dun.
What a cliche. How cliched was that? Singing the Jaws theme. You're a carp. What a jerk. Andy the carp.